ER doctors at Reddit, which of your patients came the closest to winning a Darwin Award? Myself. Honestly, I got put under with an IV and afterwards they tried to help me into a wheelchair. Duck that. I don't need a chair. I slurred as I ate it. One of my patients came in with second and third degree burns all the way up his right arm. It was winter and his pickup wouldn't start. So he put a match in the gas tank to melt the frozen gasoline. One of my patients, male, in his 30s, tried to follow a healthy trend and made a medium rare chicken recipe. Results: severe amoebic dysentery and colitis, almost resulting in bowel perforation. Burns are fun. 1. Decided the gas in the car was dead and threw a few gallons on a bonfire to get rid of it. Spent a month in the burn unit. When he woke up, he told his elderly dad to go ahead and burn the rest of that old gas out back so we can get the car started. I had a long conversation with him. 2. High on shrooms. A man jumped chest first into a fire pit. Miraculously, he was saved by his friends with seemingly minor injuries. And then immediately turned around and jumped back into the pit. 3 months in the burn unit. A patient with a methamphetamine addiction attached a Jubilee clip to the base of his D as a DIY cock ring and then promptly forgot about it for several days before presenting to the ED with a severely vascularly compromised D. He hadn't even come in because of that though. It was an incidental finding when undressing him for a secondary survey after he fell from a roof and broke his ankle. We also have very frequent patient presentations, 5-6 per week, having missed dialysis for 1-2 weeks and returning scarily high potassium levels. Anecdote from Navy corpsman attached to Marines. Marine goes to the admin medic on duty. Doc, what's bothering you? Marine. Marine 1. I have a scorpion sting. Doc, okay. Where? Marine 1. On my nutsack. Doc, okay. Have a seat over there. Next. What brings you here, Marine? Marine 2. I have a scorpion sting. Doc, ooh, okay. Where? Marine 2. On my nutsack. Doc, hold on. You. Other Marine. Come here. Marine 1. Yes, Doc. Doc, you both have scorpion stings? Marine 1. Roger, Doc. Doc, on your nuts? Marine 2. Roger, Doc. Doc, why? Marine 1. We were bored. And I had caught a scorpion earlier. We had a contest to see who could get stung in the nuts the most without quitting. Marine 2. Beaming with pride, I won. I was junior anesthesia trainee. I treated a man who injected poppy juice into his radial artery. He almost lost his hand and he required multiple plastic surgery procedures. A few months later, old mate is back in theater for a repair of the other side of his forearm. He has been riding a bicycle holding onto an idling chainsaw with his other arm. He was riding around cutting down letterboxes. He slipped and chainsawed the good side of the arm he injected poppy juice into. Then there was the youth who saw what he thought was a snake. He went to confirm by picking it up and it bit him. He remained curious, so he picked it up again and was bitten again. We live in an area of Australia where every snake is venomous. Edit. Here is a page on snakes in Tasmania. The most likely snake involved in this story is the white-lipped snake. Closest, I had a patient who needed me to complete his home circumcision. Not a doctor, though was a corpsman in the military. One of the Marines attached to my unit approached me one day and wanted me to personally circumcise him. He didn't trust any of the doctors. I had a guy get voluntarily defibrillated. Let's just say he was a Mountain Dew type of guy and he probably isn't long for this world anyway. Our conversation yielded some comical answers for all the wrong reasons. Not an ED, but hematology. We called a guy and told him to come in yesterday afternoon because his routine blood tests before clinic were extremely abnormal, and we needed to start him on urgent treatment. He didn't come in until today because it was raining yesterday. He's now very unwell. The one that is a near miss I can't think of off the top of my head modded the electronics on a vape, causing the lithium battery to explode in the right front pocket of his pants, resulting in an extremely severe burn about a foot to foot and a half in diameter, and burnt his hand completely below the wrist since it was in his pocket. Had his pants been a little baggier or his pocket been a little deeper, his boys would have been thoroughly roasted and or detached. I volunteered at a hospital and while on her duty a guy was brought in by 5 cops. The genius attempted to rob the school where cops get trained for guns. If you've ever seen one, you've noticed all the guns are bright red and made of rubber. He parked a van up against the building and cut the wire cover off the window. When that didn't work, he walked along the top of the fence with his hands on the wall trying to get to an overhang. He was spotted and while the guns may be fake, the dog asked. I see quite a lot of successful award winners. But one nominee stands out. You'd be surprised how many men jump out of a window during an argument with their wives. One guy did it but apparently forgot he lived on the 6th floor. Landed on a bus. Which partially broke his fall. But then he fell off the bus and onto a spiked fence. The fence impaled him and, get this, ripped open his scrotum and amputated one testicle. He was also disemboweled by another spike and shattered his spine and pelvis. He survived, but was paralyzed from the waist down. And he lost the other testicle when it got infected and had to be removed. He didn't have kids, so a true Darwin Award. According to the doctor in my life, don't stick random stuff up your ass. We get these guys in the ER all the time and we hate having to fist them to get it out. Me. I swallowed a pin and while it was in the back of my throat I had two choices. Cough it up and risk scratch my throat or swallow it and let my stomach acid disintegrate it. Had to get surgery. A guy arrived at the ER after he ate a few pounds of cherries without spitting the stones, so he had to be operated to get them out. The chief doctor came to see the x-ray while the man was being prepared for surgery and said good thing he didn't eat peaches. Today I had a patient with a head injury having fallen out of a tree. He was trying to climb said tree to fetch his shoe. After he made a sober bet he could throw his own shoe over the tree. Dude was in his 40s. He lost the bet, his shoe, and won a concussion. Not quite Darwin Award. Still dumb. A patient I was involved in caring for decided to see if he could fix the noise in his running lawnmower by putting his fingers under the guard to clear the blockage. A few cuts later, that didn't work. Decided to try it again. Lost 2 fingers. I was a scribe in the ER. We saw a patient who had been drinking and started to feel nauseated while in the car. Her daughter, who was driving, said something like, "You better not throw up in my car." So this lady, who apparently wasn't wearing a seat belt, had the great idea to open the door while on the highway to throw up. EMT here. Encountered a man who decided his electric bill was too high, so he turned off all the heat in his house. Giant snowstorm came and dumped about 3 feet of snow in less than 2 days. Dude thought he might have frostbite on his toes. He did, actually. So to warm himself up he drank an entire gallon of antifreeze. Apparently the name is misleading. He thought it would unfreeze him, put himself into acute renal failure and spent 6 weeks getting inpatient dialysis, among other things, before he was released. Not a doctor, but there are a bunch of stories here that qualify for a Darwin nomination. Nurse, I had a meth addict come in after he and his buddy tried to make homemade landmines with pipes and gunpowder to protect his weed grow. The landmine blew up in his hand. A doctor thought I was unconscious and was flirting with the nurse. Proceeded to be a douchebag and make fun of my man boobs la mayo, so I looked up and told him, "I bet you I could kick your ass before security gets here," and I was restrained and was given a tranquilizer. My mom used to work in a hospital. She used to tell us horror stories of patients. 2 that stood out in my head. 1. Person had a gastric sleeve operation and, to celebrate recovery, decided to drink loads of soda. They drank so much that the carbonation expanded their stomach to the point where the incision ruptured. 2. We had a massive ice storm 1 year and power was out for weeks. One family decided to keep warm by bringing their grill inside the house. All 4 family members had carbon monoxide poisoning. They were very lucky to survive. My brother is a RAND doctor and has some good stories. He once had a lady come in who had had a cucumber shoved so hard up her bottom that it had broken through the wall of the lower intestine and disappeared into her abdominal cavity. When she turned up to hospital in a lot of pain, it was essentially floating up by her liver. She needed surgery to remove it, and to try to salvage her lower bowel, which was only partially successful. She apparently insisted throughout that it was entirely consensual, and she was enjoying it until her partner slipped. the best bit. It was their first Tinder date. I had this one idiot who punched through a glass coffee table cause his stupid football team won the Super Bowl. Methodica ruined my night. Ducking hand was a pain in the ass to stitch. To top it off, his GF was there and totally freaked out by the incident, thus she wanted to break up with him. And this guy became an emotional wreck and started crying when he realized. He kept leaving the room to talk to his girl, or calling her on the phone, while I'm trying to take care of him. On top of that, he had to repeatedly get sprays because despite washing his hand there were still glass remaining. And he was extremely impatient due to this. At one point he wanted to walk out, hand ducked up and all. I didn't care if he left. I had other patients to worry about. His GF however convinced him to stay. I have never met an idiot of that degree in my life and I hope I never meet him again. He deserves the Darwin Award. Damn this thread for making me remember him. I think this question might be better suited for M's. I was in Middle Tennessee, Cookeville, Crossville, working M's. Only been out there 6 months, so I was very unfamiliar with the area and the kinds of people that inhabited the towns. My bus gets dispatched to chemical burns at Walmart. Upon arrival we enter the store and I asked the manager that was waiting for us, where is the pool section? Being from Florida, I assumed some dum-dums were messing around with the pool cleaning products. He looked at me very confused and responded with out at the end of the parking lot. My partner and I hop back in the ambulance and drive to the back corner where we see a four-door sedan with the trunk open. Two white males slumped over, one on the ground with his back against the back tire and the other laying head first out of the back seat. I smelt something very odd as soon as my door was opened. Stepped out and before I took my first step my partner says, get back in the bus now. Turns out there two were cooking meth in the trunk of their car and it exploded. Partner called hazmat and they took it from there. From my doctor uncle who heard it down the grapevine. He works upstairs. A guy came in because he decided to snort pure capsaicin. He actually died. I'm very convinced he would have won a Darwin Award if his family applied him. A patient undergoing telemetry for preoperative assessment for epilepsy had electrodes implanted in their brain subdurally. Patient got bored after 2 weeks or sitting around doing nothing with no seizures and so pulled them out. Amazingly there were no sequelae. Obligatory, not a doctor, but a witness. Watched my dad hold his scotch in one hand and steady a piece of wood in the other. So my 7-year-old brother could use a full-size axe to split the wood. They were able to reattach my dad's finger, but he's never had much use of it. Had a gentleman shoot up heroin while on the job at a construction site. Apparently started falling asleep and propped his head up with the business end of a nail gun, with his finger in the trigger. Survived. Relatively unharmed. Save the 3-4-inch nail that extended from under his jaw upwards into his mouth. Successfully removed in surgery. I was playing with Ultul and fire, like plastic bottle rockets, whoosh bottle and jet jars. Well, one day I had to take off the welding glove to tight the base of the gas rocket. Then I fire it. At the moment I clicked the spark plug button I realized I was missing a glove and I saw like a slow motion of the skin in my hand turning red brown and ripple over itself before feeling any pain. Not a doctor, but I've been to the ER a few times, and seen some things. I was in the waiting with a rather nasty infection, strep throat that said hey duckets, let's go scarlet fever, and this guy was wheeled in by his friend, brother, not really sure. What I am sure of, is that you shouldn't be carrying your D around in a Ziploc baggie with ice. No idea how this happened, but goddamn. Not a doctor, but an EMTI. I'm going to go with the patient who was at a bonfire with friends and fell into the fire. His blood alcohol level was 0.28. He was also on seizure medication. Third degree burns to his entire left arm. First and second to his abdomen and leg. He went into a 2-1 AV block during the 2-hour 20-minute ride to the burn center, resulting in a heart rate of 42 and blood pressure somewhere around 70/30. Play stupid games. Win stupid prizes. My dad is an ER nurse. His favorite quote from a lady is, "My foot hurt, so I shot it." She had indeed shot herself in the foot. We had a 16-year-old put a NuvaRing birth control ring around her wrist. should be inserted intravenously. I for one was impressed that she got it to fit around her wrist. It's so small. Had a man in his late 60s present with no bowel movement in 7 days. You know this is going to be bad. Expected impacted bowel. It was impacted alright. Radiology showed an inverted 12 ounces by glass in his bowel. Story from my mom, who was an ER nurse practitioner. A man came in with his D stuck in a mini grill. Apparently him and his wife were doing some ultra kinky it, and when circulation cut off to his D, the end of it that was stuck in the grill inflated to the size of a water balloon, so they had to saw the grill off. Wanted a smoke. Leant over the hob to light up with oxygen running through a mask round his neck. Brought in without eyebrows. This happens fairly often. Put Vaseline in the microwave to melt it and injected that into his D to enlarge it. Did this a few times before it went purple. Out of the ED there was this couple I saw that were having trouble conceiving. Turned out the guy was ejaculating into her belly button because that's where the baby goes they win. No genes were being passed on that way.